Hi, I'm John Butterworth. I am the chair of anesthesiology department at the Virginia Commonwealth University in Richmond, Virginia. In addition to being a member of the Board of Trustees, I've been a member of the society for now approximately 35 years. I spend about 20% of my time is spent actually doing clinical anesthesia. That means that the majority of my time is spent on, administrative and scholarly activities. When I got to medical school, my initial, I went through several different specialty choices, and when I graduated, the plan was for me to become a neurosurgeon. My problem was I realized that neurosurgery wasn't the only thing I was interested in, and I rotated on anesthesia and realized that that was a field that allowed me to interact with all sorts of different areas of medicine. And I noticed that the anesthesiologists seemed to be happy, that it was striking how much happier they were than so many of the other specialists. I have a real interest in history. I have a fair amount of time each day as I'm walking my dog, so I listen to history podcasts. I'm a great believer in technology. I've learned amazing things through podcasts over the last couple of years. The dog doesn't realize I'm not paying full attention to him while I'm listening to these just absolutely wonderful lectures. And so I guess what most people don't know is I'm just addicted to podcasts. What I'm most passionate about is I think we need to think like Wayne Gretzky. I mean, we need to be skating to where the puck will be. And to me, what we need to be is heading our field, heading our training to where medicine and where anesthesiology will be in the future, and not be constrained by wherever it is we are now and all those great memories of where we used to be, but to figure out what's important for the future. I'm not going to pretend that it's an easy thing to do. That's what I'm passionate about is trying to figure out where the puck's going to be. It would be really nice to know how anesthesia works. Now, we kind of give it to people, they're anesthetized, and then we stop giving it, and they wake up and go about their business. And it'd be nice if I could tell you we actually understand either of those processes. But we don't. So it'd be nice to know how the drugs work. That would be nice. I mean, there's so much related to taking care of critically ill patients, how best to take care of patients with various critical illnesses like infections and sepsis, and how best to take care of patients with cardiac disease, and how best to make the whole process of having anesthesia and surgery more predictable and safer. I see IARS as essentially a non-political voice for the specialty, and in particular for the anesthesia scholars worldwide. That's a wonderful freedom to have, that we can worry about the specialty, and we can worry about patients, and we can worry about science. And the other great thing is the international. It brings together, in a productive way, the anesthesia personnel all over the world. Well, I think that the future of medicine and the future of anesthesia is incredibly bright. Now, my wife tells me that I'm just optimistic to an insane degree, but and perhaps that's true. But it just seems to me that if you're focused on what's going to be important in the future, the opportunities are spectacular. And the people who I see in medicine who are demoralized are the people who expected things to stay, they trained and whatever, and they didn't expect anything to change. You know, I'm going to be 65 years old this year. I mean, I should be the one complaining about all this stuff, but if you want to keep up, if you see where the puck is going, the field's incredibly bright. There's new stuff all the time. And it isn't the way it was, but there's an awful lot of things to be happy about.